offered, you know, a guy who can pressure and put coming. We've seen a guy do well against him like that, right? So,
by the way, I talked to Mikey about you. Because Mikey's talking to Dana White about fighting on UFC pass and maybe in 1 year to fight in the UFC. And I told Mikey
that MMA?
And I told Mikey that you fought in MMA. Did you know that, Robert? He was an MMA fighter. So you could just teach him the basics before he goes to like UFC training center. Basic MMA moves, skills.
Good. So I mean I owned my own MMA training center before.
Robert, you know that? You can train Mikey in MMA too? I think you should start.
A little grappling.
All you just teach him how to defend takedowns. Yeah. His hands will do the talking. Yeah, yeah. But exactly. If he fights, let's say, a guy like Cub Swanson that likes to box, yeah, or some puncher, that would be big.
But anybody, no matter who they are, they would know they have the grappling advantage, right?
So. Yeah, but Mikey's an athlete and he learns quick.
Good athletes do. You know? Like Jose Ramirez, the funny thing is he never wrestled. And I wrestled and did jiu-jitsu. And when he was younger, you know, guys, we were messing around. He'd wrestle around and stuff, you know. And he got so strong and he's such a good natural athlete that Jose, I would lock up and just be playing Jose around. Dude, I couldn't even move him around. Like, I couldn't get him.
John Gotti.
Easily, you know, I couldn't get him because he naturally has a feel for it.
Who?
Jose. We're talking about wrestling.
So,
Robert, what Charles is saying, Charles wants to know if you could get a cage, or maybe outside a cage somewhere.
We should do an extra little. We should do
an MMA thing.
Una plataforma y un tejabato.
Yeah, with a cage right there, so you could do some fucking MMA.
I think so.
Right,
who? Okay, where can you put the cage though? Outside?
We're building another area. We could
expand here?
A little more, or over there on that side.
Tyson's house. It's already half a cage.
Tyson's retired. But you know, if you build a cage, I will bring you MMA fighters, Robert. Because they could do the boxing here. They could do their MMA with their MMA coach.
We could.
Oh, you have a cage.
Yeah.
You have a fence. But yeah, you're right.
We just put cement
and a cover for the heat. I think that's a great idea. Listen, I could bring MMA superstars to train here. It's camp. They can stay in the house if they want or rent a hotel.
You know what? What do you think is cheaper for me to do? But like, build four, like little
bungalows.
I got the roof exactly. Or put in like more like those trailers, like mobile homes.
I think a bungalow. It's here.
Right here.
Yeah.
Four right here.
I think it's beautiful. They have their own bathroom, right? Their own little kitchen.
They don't have their own bathroom and kitchen. That's what I say. Like, say, Joshua Franco, who's now a world champion.
Yeah, he needs his own space, his clean.
Own
yep.
His own little, he could come and eat with Chef Chan. Yeah. But he has his own little place.
Where did the tree fall down, Robert? There's a tree that fell. The neighbor is like Dr. Brown.
We haven't.
He's been very friendly about it. He wasn't a jerk.
We gotta tell him. Let's see him.
Dr. Brown, Emmett Brown.
Hector's gonna come and fix it. He told me. I don't know which tree it was, man.
But it's this neighbor, right?
Yeah, it was this guy.
Very friendly. You know, he was in the military for like 35 years.
Yeah.
He's a very high officer.
What tree was it?
Over there in the end.
Oh yeah, let's talk to him.
Dr. Brown! Emmett Brown, how you feeling? Good, it's a hot day today.
Okay, so my guy went back to Texas emergency, but I already told my other guys, he's gonna come take all this, he told me for sure Saturday.
Okay.
Okay? Just, you know, the guy, you know, the one you were talking to?
Sure.
He left yesterday emergency back to Texas. Oh, that's where he's from.
Did you punch it and broke it? Like, you were mad?
This is a big fucking...
I would have loved to have said yes, however.
Robert, you know, he's serving like six different wars.
Good. Congratulations, man.
Yeah.
Thanks for the service. That's awesome.
No problem, man. Like I said, I just figured I'd clean off some of the little stuff.
Yeah, but yeah, Hector told me you're coming Saturday and
yeah, and fix it.
Smaller, that's huge.
Yeah, it.
Lucky it didn't fall on your truck.
Yeah. Duh. Well, at least I found a barber yesterday. No longer.
You're right.
That's true.
All right, got it. Thank you very much.
So Saturday morning sometime?
Yes, he said he'd be here Saturday for sure.
Okay. Not a problem.
Thank you very much.
Do you have any horses, donkeys, pigs?
No.
Why not?
Well, because I had two kids.
How long you been here?
Oh God, 35, 36.
Oh, right? Oh wow. But everybody else here has horses.
A lot of them do, quite a few of them do not. Like I said, the people I bought it off of had kind of like a small fence halfway down the yard, and they had a horse, but I just decided, no. And when I put up the fence here in the back, you know, when the kids were little especially, mm-hmm. you know, they had essentially their own park.
Yeah.
And, you know, unfortunately, I've kind of let the tennis court go a little bit, but, yeah, like I said, when I was growing up, I played a lot of basketball and stuff like that, so, you know, I had taught the kids mm-hmm. how to do that, and yeah. we've been having fun.
That's cool.
But, yeah, like I said, I just went ahead and, you know.
Robert, look at this piece of wood here. It's crazy. It looks like a baseball bat.
It actually grew into the fence.
Oh, it did. That's right.
Yeah, it's it's the unusual things that happen here. Yeah. Yeah. One thing I don't know if you've noticed so much, but since living here,
that's
I've
funny.
Had. Let's see. I've killed a couple coyotes in the back, but you know, I just use a bow.
Yeah.
A couple possums.
That's crazy.
I've had. We've had peacock. Heron, eagles, red hawks, a whole mess. Before I took out the one eucalyptus that was back there in the back, we'd have like a huge murder of crows. I mean, like a couple, 200 or 300. They would nest in a eucalyptus bowl. And then I had, we had one that came in, we didn't know what it was. We called it Guck because it looked like a goose got into the duck form uh-huh. and okay. made it with a duck. Because, you know, had a green beak, web feet, whatever else, mm-hmm. but the size of a duck. I'm kind of, huh? So, you know, we took care of it for a little bit and it flew off. But, you know, like I said, the one thing that's interesting about here that you may have discovered over the past 5 or 6 years is for the most part, folks will. Hey, do whatever, and you know, as long as it's not too loud or too often or whatever, you know, like down the way there was a bunch of Samoans that moved in, and for the first couple of years they would have these big parties, which was fine, it's just that they would have fireworks out in the street and stuff, and around here it's just too dry for that.
It is too dry.
So
I'll tell Neno.
Sorry. Yeah, we should
yeah, it's bad. And so, you know, so they stopped that, but you know, other than that,
yeah,
it's been pleasant.
Did you go knock on their door and say, "Hey, stop it"?
I didn't, but a couple others that live right next to them did.
Yeah, they're very chill usually.
Yeah, well, like I say, for the most part, the neighborhood yeah. for 35, 36 years. Cool. It's only been recently that we've had any criminals show up and try to break into things. And so far, not with my house, but anyway, I guess there's a couple, you know, down the way. But for the most part, let's see, pretty much all the way up and down the street, okay, you had either retired military, CHP, state troopers, or cops. Mm-hmm. So it was pretty much maybe 2 or 3 houses. But if you wanted to break in, you might live.
Yeah.
For the rest of us,
are you shooting them with an arrow, a gun, you got a baseball bat?
I've got. Katanas. I've got swords.
Yeah, he's using a bazooka, Robert.
Yeah.
I got, you know, sticks. You know, I don't care. You know, it's either sushi or whatever. You know. You know.
That's it. No dogs, though. You need to get some dogs.
Nah.
No,
I'm the dog.
That's
there you go. All right.
All right, you guys.
All right, great.
Thanks for the heads up.
Say, yeah, don't thanks. Stay in the heat too much. It's hot today.
Oh, I know.
He's a cool dude, huh? Very chill.
Very chill.
I wanted to ask him if he saw a white van terrorizing the neighborhood, Robert.